Please listen out for words containing un. Ready? 여기는 고깃집이에요. 제 남편이 불판에 고기를 얹습니다. 버섯을 얹고 양파를 얹고 껍데기도 얹어요. 마늘은 아직 얹지 않아서 제가 말해요.
자기야, 마늘도 좀 얹어줄래? 옆에 조금만.
그래서 마늘도 얹혔어요. 체크 the correct pronunciation of un at the end of the video. 안녕하세요, 여러분. 아라쌤입니다. Hello, everyone. I'm Ara from Korean Ara. Today's lesson is about 겹받침, 니은지읒. 겹받침, 니은지읒. Do you know what the 겹받침 means? I'll tell you what the 겹받침 means first. 겹받침. 겹받침 is known as a double final consonant. 겹 means layers or things that are overlapped. And 받침 means a final consonant. So, 겹받침 is a combination of two different consonants which are written together in a final consonant position. In Korean, there are total 11 겹받침. Here are some examples. For any 겹받침, even though there are two different consonants are written in a 받침 position, only one of them is pronounced. It is not easy to predict which of two consonants will be pronounced since even native Korean people sometimes feel confused with the 겹받침 too. Of the 11 겹받침, 니은 히읗 and 리을 히읗, which you have히읗 included, are covered in the previous lesson. If you are interested in 겹받침, 니은 히읗 and 리을 히읗, please check the card link or the description below. Anyway, you will be learning 겹받침, 니은 지읒 today. There are not many words that have 겹받침, 니은 지읒 in Korean. Here are some verbs frequently used which have 겹받침, 니은 지읒. For example, 앉다, to sit, 얹다, to place something, 앉히다, to sit somebody, 얹히다, to be placed. 겹받침, 니은 지읒 is easy to pronounce since only the first consonant, 니은, is always pronounced as a 받침. For example, 앉는, 앉고, 앉아, 앉히다. In certain conditions, the letter which comes after 겹받침, 니은, 지읒 sounds different from what it is written as. So, in this lesson, I'll show you three different ways to pronounce 겹받침, 니은, 지읒. Are you ready? Let's go! Number 1. 겹받침, 니은, 지읒 plus vowel. When the 겹받침, 니은, 지읒 is followed by a vowel, only the first consonant, 니은, is pronounced and the second consonant, 지읒 becomes the initial consonant in the next syllable. For example, 얹어, 앉을, 앉으세요. This kind of sound change is called linking sounds or 연음, which is a very basic pronunciation rule in Korean. If you want to learn more about 연음, please check the previous lesson in the card link or the description below. Now, it's your turn. Repeat after me. 얹어, 앉을, 앉으세요. Very nice. Let's practice. Please pause the video and try to read the following sentences. Ready? 여기 앉으세요. 여기 앉으세요. 이 식당은 앉을 자리가 없어요. 이 식당은 앉을 자리가 없어요. Number 2. 겹받침 니은지읒 plus 히읗. When the 겹받침 니은지읒 is followed by a consonant 히읗, only the first consonant 니은 is pronounced, and the second consonant 지읒 is combined with 히읗 and sounds like 치읒. And 치읒 sound becomes the initial consonant in the next syllable. For example, 앉히고 얹혔어요. Now, it's your turn. Repeat after me. 앉히고 얹혔어요. Very good. Let's practice. Please pause the video and try to read the following sentences. Ready? 불판에 마늘도 얹혔어요. 불판에 마늘도 얹혔어요. 웨이터가 손님들을 앉히고 있어요. 웨이터가 손님들을 앉히고 있어요. 넘버 3. 겹받침 니은지읒 plus 기역 디귿 시옷 지읒. When the 겹받침 니은지읒 is followed by the consonants 기역, 디귿, 시옷, or 지읒, only the first consonant 니은 is pronounced and the second consonant 지읒 is silent. And the consonants that come after 겹받침 니은지읒 sound like this. 기역 to 쌍기역, 디귿 to 쌍디귿, 시옷 to 쌍시옷, 지읒 to 쌍지읒. For example, 앉다, 얹고, 앉지, 얹습니다. Now, it's your turn. Repeat after me. 앉다, 얹고, 앉지, 얹습니다. Very nice. Let's practice. Please pause the video and try to read the following sentences. Ready? 여기에 앉지 마세요. 여기에 앉지 마세요. 불판에 고기를 얹습니다. 불판에 고기를 얹습니다.
Check the correct pronunciation of 언. 여기는 고깃집이에요. 제 남편이 불판에 고기를 얹습니다. (목소리) 얹고 양파를 얹고 껍데기도 얹어요. 마늘은 아직 얹지 않아서 제가 말해요.
저기야, 마늘도 좀 얹어줄래? 옆에 조금만.
그래서 마늘도 얹혔어요.
땡스 포 워칭. I hope you enjoyed this video. 그럼 공부 열심히 하세요. Please study hard. 우리 다음 시간에 봐요. See you next time. 안녕히 계세요.